Moraes, the champion, no longer flying under the radar. Wakamatsu, center circle. Moraes, huge, tall for a flyweight. Wakamatsu's gonna set that right hand. One chance is all he needs, one opening.
This is what we saw from Adriano in the DJ matchup, is this utilization of the space. He really understands footwork and how to look for these openings. Yuya is just waiting patiently, trying to unleash that right hand.
You know Adriano would have trained for that for months. He knows that's the prime weapon of the little piranha. But outside the kick from Wakamatsu. Takes here from Wakamatsu. Moraes, a nice head kick there from the champion. Another head kick from Moraes. He's got some snap to it, so it's fast. Maybe doesn't pivot, maybe doesn't talk, but he's got snap.
There's the first stance change from Moraes. Look for him to go southpaw and then start throwing those kicks. Nice jab landed by Yuya.
Outside thigh kick from the champion, then goes the inside thigh.
Yuya looks relaxed, composed, calm, just choosing his shots carefully. I like these touches though by
Moraes.
Both of them actually.
Moraes is landing the more shots at the moment. Yuya hasn't really thrown anything.
But Yuya looks patient though. He doesn't look, he's not too fidgety. He's not overextending. He's very calm and real patient. Adriano's landed some kicks, landed some shots, moving around, trying to find his angles.
You can feel the intensity. Tremendous respect for both men's skill sets.
Stop! Athlete, stop!
And Mohamed Sulaiman wants more action.
Action. Ready to go! Let's go!
He's basically saying, fellas, the filling out process, it ends now.
Man, he's got 25 minutes, though. You gotta give him a chance to just sort of adjust to this moment right now.
Okay. Let's hear from Rich Franklin. Rich, your thoughts on the halfway point of the opening round.
Yeah, I'm with Mitch on that. You got 25 minutes, so this is one of those matches where you got to pace yourself. And keep in mind, both of these guys have knockout power, so one little mistake and you get caught, and that's lights out for you.
Both men exchange your knees in the clinch, dead center of the circle. Jab two from Wakamatsu, misses. Moraes, leg kick, counter there from Wakamatsu.
Wakamatsu's trying to counter the leg kick with some hands, but Adriano is so fast.
Outside leg kick, Adriano. Some rigidity already above the lead knee of Yuya Wakamatsu. Moraes face. Long reaching left hand there from Wakamatsu. No home for the right hand yet, however.
Stop!
And another caution here.
One more time, yellow card.
Last warning, or he's going to tip into the pocket and go yellow cards. And that will mean a 10% purse deduction.
Moraes has yet to really fully commit to getting into range. And Yuya is just taking the center and waiting for him to come in. It's Moraes that's dancing along the outside, really looking for his spots carefully.
Moraes has the takedown. That was nice. He gets it.
Beautifully timed, but Yuya pops right back up. He does not want to tangle with Adriano on the ground. He told me his sole mission is if he hits the ground is to get back up. But Adriano is a high-level black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and he easily steps over into half guard.
Yuya did say, underestimate my ground skills at your own peril. Half guard position. Wakamatsu trying to get back to his feet. He gets there now, takes the back standing of the champion.
Crowd appreciation. Power from Yuya Wakamatsu as he's able to bridge out of that. As Moraes gives up his back now. Good wrestling so far from Yuya. Let's see if Adriano chooses to separate those hands and spin.
That's what? 10 seconds.
Yep, just that. Goes chest to chest. Yuya presses him up against the wall. Might ride out the time here.
Okay, we go to the towels. End of round one. Don't forget, this is judged as an overall contest and not as five individual rounds. Folks, also, you can vote. We're giving you the opportunity. You get to award one performance bonus of the night. Head to one social media platforms to vote now. Who do you think? Who deserves a performance bonus? Okay, let's go to Rich Franklin. Rich, your thoughts after 5 minutes.
Yeah, you know, you saw the referee there warned him twice about stalling, and I think that takedown was a result of that right there, because Adriano was doing such a good job of managing that distance that Yuya felt the pressure from the referee, doesn't want the first deduction, overcommitted slightly, and Adriano was able to land that takedown.
Ready to rock and roll, second round set for five. Flyweight World Championship on the line. That's 1X from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Referee Mohammed Sulaiman,
let's go,
getting a little fed up in the opening round with the lack of commitment from both men. They have two cautions, no yellow cards yet, however. Will they turn it up? Inside leg kick, hard the femoral profunda there from Wakamatsu. That right hand is cocked and ready. Will he pull the trigger?
Action, red!
I think Yuya is going to have to be a little bit more cautious if this thing hits the ground again. He doesn't really want to explode like that, because now Moraes is going to expect that type of explosion, and he's going to have a counter for it. Yuya needs to be a little bit more technical on his get-ups.
Moraes can be a surprising and cagey customer. Did begin his martial arts career in Capoeira. Nice knee on the inside from the chat. Jump in there! Good airball. Decent hang time too there, Dragon.
Yeah, Adriano is explosive. And Yuya goes, that's nothing. You didn't even touch me. Let's get back to dancing.
Fake there from Wakamatsu.
That's what Yuya needs to do. He needs to have a little bit more feints, just kind of draw out some movement. I'd like to see him score with some hand combinations and maybe leg kick. He landed a leg kick in the first five, and there's a right hand touch right there.
Counter right from the leg kick of Moraes.
Because what the leg kicks are going to do, it's going to slow down this constant movement that's coming from Moraes. Yuya needs a stationary target. He does his best work when he catches you coming in and you're not moving as much.
Yeah, but the crowd are booing now, too, and it may not be long before Mohammed Sulaiman issues another caution or maybe even a yellow card. The crowd getting restless in this flyweight championship match. Another hand right there from Wakamatsu. Singapore Indoor Stadium wants more action. Now they engage. Wakamatsu pushes him back against the fence. Nice corking knee, and another one from Yuya.
This is the new level of Yuya's game that we saw him at. He went over to Sanford MMA, started working with Ung Lah and Martin Nguyen, and he really developed his cage wrestling and his ability to stop takedowns and also go for takedowns. So this is a new level for Yuya.
Rich Franklin, if you're in the corner of the champion, Adriano, what are you telling him to do?
I would tell him to just back off that cage, move around a bit, and keep managing that distance the way that he was. I also, though, when he's managing that distance, would like to see him being just a bit more offensive. There's little scores on the scorecard here, but nothing that's really adding up that's giving anybody a decisive lead. And you got to keep in mind, we're almost 10 minutes into this match at this point.
The crowd got excited momentarily. But Rich, I'll ask you this one. Have the crowd been right to boo and jeer? Has there been a lack of action?
It depends on what you actually value as a spectator of this sport. I realize that there's 25 minutes in this match. I personally like watching these guys just jockeying back and forth with their foot position and angling off to see who's winning that little battle. But these are my, like, tiny details that the trained eye can see that allows somebody like Adriano to set up for a kick like that. And if you're not trained to see that, then you won't respect those little things and you expect these bigger moves to come out.
Adriano's starting to confuse Yuya with this movement. You can see him switching back and forth. He was able to just get that head kick up there, and Yuya got frozen a little bit. He's kind of stuck here taking pictures. Yuya needs to be more offensive now. I'd like to see him utilize those leg kicks. It's slow down this movement of Adriano.
Adriano faked a jumping knee, then went downstairs with a leg kick. Overhand right from Yuya, then throws a wild left hook. shoots in the chop. Lodging back against the fence, there's a knee on the inside. Right hand from Adriano. This is more like it.
I like the way Adriano's mixing things up. He's doing a great job of threatening the takedown. He might not score it, but at least he gets Yuya thinking about the takedown threat. And then he's taken to the air with those flying knees. I think he sees something there.
Is the jaw of Wakamatsu. They're tagging the flying knee as a roundhouse kick.
Adriano's starting to up the tempo with these kicks. He's mixing things up well. Because you can see the wide stance that Yuya has, kind of a karate-based style. And now Adriano's starting to land leg kicks both inside and outside. And he's scoring.
Takes the jab, does Wakamatsu. Caught about a high right roundhouse. Into the round. Crowd not appreciative of the action in this flyweight world title match.
Well, these guys, the crowd's been spoiled all night, Michael. We've had constant action as a beautiful takedown right there from Adriano. But Yuya did a great job of getting back up again. Adriano threatens with a takedown, beautiful positioning, good defense coming from Yuya Wakamatsu. Nice little right hand kind of threatened there. And again, Adriano takes to the air, pushes off, gets him back into position, and starts to look again.
Put your weight on your leading leg. Excellent.
We're
going to the third round. Let's start over again.
Okay, the corner of Moraes want a fresh start from the third round. As the circle door closes, Yuya Wakamatsu his chance for gold. Does not want to rue any missed opportunities.
Yuya's got to deal with this movement of Adriano. He's having a hard time. You can see him throwing these shots, and he's just airballing. He can't quite reach Adriano because of this elusive movement and stance switches. Adriano's very good at understanding range and distance. And this space, he's a veteran. He's been in here a long time. He knows how to utilize the dimensions of the circle.
Nice check there from Yuya. Adriano, lots of movement, and the referee doesn't like it. I think he's going to go in his pocket now. Yellow card coming. 10% course deduction. If it happens, let's see. Okay, double yellow card. Rich Franklin, your thoughts on this?
At this point in time, this is probably warranted, particularly with what Mitch said, because we've had a really exciting night of fights so far. The thing I don't like about this match with these two athletes is neither one has a significant lead, and this is going to end up coming down if they continue running to this pace, with one of these guys just making a mistake and winning off of a slight margin at the end.
Oh, that was nice from Adriano, the duck under, to take the back. He gets one hook in, Yuya smartly goes to the wall and utilizes the cages almost like a defense.
Now the yellow card seemed to work. Adriano Moraes has upped the intensity here.
I gotta say, Michael, I am very impressed with Yuya Wakamatsu's takedown defense. Adriano has not been able to keep him on the floor.
Calf kick, corking knee from Wakamatsu. What is Yuya looking to do here, Dragon?
He's got underhook, and he's also going into between the hips there. He's looking for something. He's trying. He might try to reap out a leg and pull him into a takedown, but I think he might just be looking for possible separation here.
Yep. Stop.
Some tape coming loose on the glove there of Adriano. 3 minutes, 5 remaining. Third round set for 5. Flyweight World Championship. Still to come tonight, folks. What's up? Demetrius Johnson, the super fight, is up next. Lots of instructions in Yuya's corner as he throws a high look around, then goes downstairs to the inside thigh.
And Yuya needs to be a little bit more active. He's getting a little bit gun shy. He's doing a good job of defending, not taking a lot of damage.
Jumping,
he's not being very active.
Yuya,
there he goes. Yuya with the takedown now. Let's see if he tries to suck the hips away and keep him down, or if he just tries to get back up. Knee to the ground opponent, perfectly legal.
Right in front of our commentary position. A charge for Yuya Wakamatsu. Gets back to his feet as the champion. Yuya!
Nice double leg there. Was able to get the hands clasped, picked him up, put him down. Adriano pops right back up to his feet, though.
Knees from Yuya. The outside left thigh. Adriano grabs a leg.
Nice little hip switch right there to change angle for the single leg, and that just created separation.
Crowd appreciating it. Very educated crowd in Singapore. Jab from Yuya.
That was nice. He's got to do more of that. He's got to be more active with the hands.
Gets out of the way of the round kick. 1:30 remains in this third round. Takes here. Overhand right. Yuya takes the champ down again, Dragon.
Another takedown for Yuya Wakamatsu. Who would have suspected that one right there? Let's see if he chooses to pass guard or if he's just going to sit there in the guard and drop a little bit of ground and pound. Again, Dracula's jumping on the neck, though. He's got a good squeeze from this position.
Oh, it's over.
And he got it.
It's over.
Wow.
Adriano Moraes retains the Flyweight Championship.
Don't give Adriano your neck. He will choke you out.
He did what he said he would do. Submit Yuya Wakamatsu. Just when it seemed that Yuya had the momentum with three takedowns. Just when it seemed the pendulum had swung the way of the Japanese fighter. Adriano Moraes goes over to world multi-time BJJ champion Leo Vieira. Also the great Hento Gracie. I'm on our mini luminaries here, Circle Star. A BJJ win from an amazing athlete. Have a look at this, jumping roundhouse there. Yuya the takedown. Watch the knee to the head, coming up. Beautifully done. Yuya puts him down. Wonderful work here for Yuya. It seemed like it was all going Yuya's way. Have a look at this, where he gets into trouble. The neck is taken, the choke is sunk in. Referee Muhammad Sulaiman on top of it. And it's over. There's the tap from Yuya Wakamatsu. Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
To present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Sityodong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohammed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 3:58 in the third round for your winner by way of guillotine choke and still undisputed ONE Flyweight Champion of the World, Adriano Moraes.